ones that are the best for our psychological health and well-being. What if we're not alone on this earth? So much of our mental health problems, I believe, stems from this sense that we are a lonely species. We're the only folks in town. When you increase the biodiversity of a community, so does the psychological well-being. Physical health. People have been tested on treadmills, indoor gyms, compared to expending, burning exactly the same number of calories as doing it outside in green exercise, like eating some kind of things that animals. What they found is that both groups get better. People on the treadmills, their blood pressure gets better, et cetera, et cetera. Psychological well-being. But the people who burn exactly the same number of calories but do it in nature get even better. There's a margin of improvement that we do not understand. And it has to do with who we are. It has to do with something that goes very deep in us. It's that place in the heart that I was talking about. But it's at a molecular level. E.O. Wilson at Harvard talks about the biophilia hypothesis, which is that we are genetically wired, programmed to have affiliation with nature. Studies have been done all over the world of what kind of images human beings, no matter where they live, urban, suburban, whatever, no matter where they live, what kind of images are they attracted to? Humans all over the world are most attracted to images of nature. And of those, of the landscapes, the number one image that human beings are attracted to is the image of the savanna. It looks a lot like the green one, the savanna. Where are we from? It doesn't prove there's a genetic link, but it certainly raises the conversation. I think that there is so much that Charlotte can do, in addition to everything you're already doing. Across North America, in the last few years, Soul Nature Network has been tracking this. There are now over 120 regional state campaigns to get kids out. Some of these started, one of the earliest was Cincinnati. The whole city decided. They called it, at the beginning, they called it Leave No Child Inside Cincinnati. Then they thought about that for a